wa ta'ala tells us about Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. I want to draw one example, just one. I told you there are many, but let's draw one. Do you know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is it in your right hand, O Musa? Do you think Allah did not know? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew exactly, better than Musa alayhi salam, what was in his hand. But this was an opportunity for Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to communicate with his Rabb. Now, the proper answer, if someone told you, what is in your right hand? I'll say, there is a paper in my right hand. That's it. But Musa alayhi salatu wasalam decided, you know what, this is a chance. I might not get it in the near future again. Let me seize it and speak as much as I want to Allah. هي عصاي أتوكأ عليها وأهش بها على غنمي ولي فيها مآرب أخرى. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is my stick. هي عصاي أتوكأ عليها. Sometimes I lean on it, ya Allah. Allah didn't ask him what you do with it. He says, sometimes I lean on it, ya Allah. أتوكأ. And sometimes I use it for my flock. I use it to direct the flock, ya Allah. And he didn't stop there. And sometimes I use it for other things as well, ya Allah. Allahu Akbar. Look at how beautiful it is. He is speaking to his creator and he's continuing uttering and uttering. What do we learn from that? The closest we are to our creator is salah in sujood. But with us, it's the other way around. We want to dart up again as though there are springs on our foreheads from spring master. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So as we go down, it rebounds, it comes back up again. Allahu Akbar. Yet, we are supposed to be learning from Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. This is the opportunity that you get to be close to Allah, to communicate with Him. Why do you want to come up so suddenly? Take your time. And this is why we always tell the men and the women folk that don't leave your car running and say, you know what, let me quickly read my salah and come. Switch it off. Take the battery out if you want. It might be your last salah. When you come for salah, it must be complete concentration. Don't be bothered about time. Those people who complain about time, they haven't understood the lesson here. The same applies to the women folk. Don't leave your stove, turn it on and say, let me quickly read my salah and come and check on it. Switch it off, put the pot aside, read your salah, then come and do your cooking. We can't give preference to a pot of food over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nor can we give preference to a motor vehicle over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here is Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. What a beautiful example. He spoke so much because he knew it's an opportunity. We too, when it comes to salah, let's take our time inshallah. May Allah make us really achieve the coolness of our eyes in salah. Qurratu ayni li fi salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says regarding the coolness of his eyes in salah. May Allah do that for us as well.